Living in Liberty Township, I thought there's really no need. These kids all have up here. You know, they're families, good families, and you just really don't realize the need that is around you. I think mentoring for me has just, it's really given me a purpose other than my work and home life, and it makes me feel like I'm giving back, and that it's just such a little amount of time that you give with all that I get back from Mia. The minute I saw her beautiful dark hair and beautiful dark eyes and just the sweetest face and so shy, and I immediately fell in love with her.
I really like Tuesdays because it's WizKids Day and I get to see Tracy. And I still like Thursdays because it's very close to Friday.
I decided to go from just tutoring to mentoring. As soon as I got to know Mia, I knew I wanted to spend more time with her, and I knew that Mia needed someone in her life.
I really like to hang out with her a lot.
It really was an easy process to get into the mentoring.
I used to live with my grandma a long time ago.
Mia's family, they're very loving people. However, they have had many struggles in the past several years with substance abuse, with family separation, and she lived with her dad and her grandmother for quite a few years and her two brothers until her dad passed away this past year of a drug overdose. And Mia's grandmother had called me. She was away at WizKids camp, and her grandmother had called to ask if I would go with her to pick Mia up from camp so that I could be there when they told her that her dad passed away. So I felt that showed how important our relationship is, that her family thought enough of me to want me to be there to help support Mia through this very difficult time. They had not lived with their mom for several years, and she had her struggles as well. She came back into the picture when their dad passed away. Their grandmother was unable to keep the kids.
Every time I read with her, I get so excited. And then when I spell out the words, I always look at her, and I'm waiting for her to smile, and she does.
I get so excited when I hear her sounding out the words and, you know, making the effort. I've taught her manners, thank you, please. And every time she says it, she looks back at me because she knows I'm going to be so excited about that. You go in with the idea that you're going to help someone be able to read better and to show more interest in reading. And that's really just such a small part of what Mia and I have shared together. You know, it's just time together. It's not really money or something special. It's just being there for her.
I like baking cookies, and she's teaching me lots of stuff. I think they taste good.
You feel like it's really your calling through God to help other people. Without mentoring, I could see Mia really struggling through the difficulties, especially in the past year that she had, and really even before that, because her family situation was one where there was, you know, difficulties. And I think just her seeing my home life, my family's home life, and how it can be. And, you know, I think it really gives her something to strive for, and she looks so forward to coming here.
I think that Tracy is just like a mom to me.
Mia has really opened up over the years that we've been together. It's been 3 years now, and she shows affection more. She's really just become one of our family. Well, if I wasn't involved in her life, I could see her heading down a path where, you know, she didn't have the structure and the caring and the loving that she needs to guide her in the right direction. And I'm always going to be there. I'm not just going to see her through sixth grade when WizKids is over. You know, it's going to be a lifelong relationship, and I want to make sure that she's okay.